Okay.
I see all right. Power of wisdom and so on. Is that what you mean?
Perfect.
No.
No, I don't think so. Why do they all wear weird hats?
You guys are starting to hear the music.
To receive, I am opening myself to believe that everything I want and everything I need, all of this and more, are waiting patiently.
Leader Elena Merriman will be sharing our meditation affirmations. Virginia Patry is out this morning, and our Handy will be sharing our message. So everybody clap for them. Yay! So as you know, we're going through some incredibly challenging times right now with the coronavirus and with all of our concerns with going on in our world today. We just pray that you have peace and calm and well-being for all of you. And please make sure that you take all the necessary precautions to keep yourself safe during this time. Our greatest desire is to have a little fun here as well. That's why we're all wearing silly hats or silly outfits. And I have with me this morning a little Yip Yip guy that a friend of mine made for me to help us have more fun during this time. And our other greatest desire is that you have a connection with everyone here and that you are inspired by today's message, the meditation, the music, and that you know that you are a blessing to us. Okay, so we're going to start with a poll question. And the question is how have you reached out in our spiritual community in the past week? Have you done that? And if so, how has it made you feel as a result of reaching out? And that poll question, you can just tap your screen and then you push chat. And if you can't do it, that's all right. But if you have an Android or an iPhone, you can just tap your screen and push chat. And then you can type in your answer. How have you reached out and how has that made you feel? Okay. And then the power of the month is wisdom. And the power is to practically apply what is known to intuitively discern and to make heart connections. And so we want to be connected with our hearts. With that wisdom, we are going to say our mission statement together to inspire spiritual transformation as a vibrant, diverse, and inclusive community. And then also with that wisdom, we will say our statement of being. Together, there is only one presence and one power in my life and in the universe, God the Good, Omnipotent. Again, we want to thank everyone for watching this service live, and especially want to thank those of you who are joining us for the very first time. Welcome to Unity of Wichita. We are honored that you are here, and we look forward to meeting you in person very soon. We really want to meet each and every one of you in person. Unity is a worldwide ministry dedicated to honoring the spirit within all of us, discovering that and empowering that. And we invite you to consider our teachings and whatever fits into your spiritual journey, whatever part of you and life you are in right now, however you want to express that is wonderful. And we just gently release the rest. We will now bless everyone who is watching now. We love you. We bless you. We appreciate you. And we behold the Christ as you. And back to you, Sam.
It popped off. That's okay. We'll just keep going.
Sickness. my strength.
The joy of the Lord. Normally, if we were having a service here in the sanctuary, this would be a time where we would hold up our prayer box and honor the prayers that have made it into this box, as well as the prayers in our heart. So today, this box will symbolize our hearts, for our hearts, each and every one of our hearts, contain the prayers that we're so intimately and passionately holding. Whether we ever give voice to these prayers or not, they are there. And just as the prayers are present, we know overall that God is fully and completely present. So in this time of prayer, we want to constantly remember our spiritual congregation here, our spiritual community, as well as the wider community and all of us as we navigate these very challenging and unique times. So we take this moment to honor your hearts and go into prayer. So we just take a moment to relax and settle our senses and attune our awareness to the presence of God. Fully and completely present, right here and right now. And we also affirm our oneness with God. God is, I am. God is, we are. We celebrate this oneness. We see, sense, and feel and know that God is present in, through, and as ourselves. And as the first line of the prayer protection says, the light of God surrounds us. Let us feel God's light right now. Let us embody and be God's light right now. And we see God's light surrounding and filling each and every person connected to our spiritual community. We see God's light surrounding and filling our leaders as they navigate us through this challenge. We see God's light surrounding and filling all of those who are in positions of service, serving the needs of humanity during this trying time. And we see God's light surrounding and filling all of us, as each and every one of us are the solution to whatever it is that we're facing. We see God's light surrounding us and filling us and flowing forth in the way of creative ideas that heal, ideas that bless, ideas that strengthen our connections with one another. All of this is God. And we see this flowing forth because it is flowing forth right now. We know this using the power of faith and the power of imagination to know that there is always more divinely going on than what it may appear on the surface. For this is wisdom. And we are so grateful for this knowing. And in the name and in the nature of the Christ indwelling, within all of us, together we say, and so it is. Amen.
Amen. Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, you can hear it. Great. Okay. Work wonders from within. Work wonders from within. That's where to look within. There's no use looking somewhere else for a path that you need to win. Work wonders from within. Be sure to look within. Just take your mind from outer fears. Don't think it's too late. Begin. In you, in me, there's power to be. In you, in me, there's power that will set us free. My course is up to me. Of course, it's up to me. So I'll set my mind to use my power. If wonders I want to see. Power up and shine, my friends.
So, can you hear me?
Yes. Okay. Go ahead.
Okay. So, I'm Elaina Marin, and I'll do our affirmation and meditation. And the affirmation is really just one sentence. So, let's say it three times. So, I'll say it once, and then we'll actually repeat it twice more. So, divine love floods my consciousness with grace, and I am guided by the wisdom of my heart. So say it with me. Divine love floods my consciousness with grace, and I am guided by the wisdom of my heart. And one more time. Divine love floods my consciousness with grace, and I am guided by the wisdom of my heart. And now, just get comfortable for the meditation. And don't get hung up on the words. If I don't say the words that you need to hear, just substitute the ones that you prefer. So, beloved Father, Mother, God, once more, here we are, and we call ourselves forward into your ever-present, everywhere-present love and light and sound. And that sound being the divine essence, that unstruck sound, that vibration that God brought forth, the creator, the source, the divine essence brought forth, that created all of this in which we live and move and have our being. And we're so grateful to be here and be holding the light in these challenging times. We're so grateful that we can live and move from the wisdom of our hearts. So now, allow yourself to settle your consciousness, gently breathing. Opening in a greater way to this presence that is spirit, this presence that is the essence of all life. And as you breathe, as you just do this most natural of processes, allow your awareness to focus on your spiritual heart, which can start in the area of your physical heart, but is much, much bigger. And this is the place of loving. This is the place of joy. This is the place within where we connect with that infinite presence of God from which we originate. And as we focus, we become aware that this light has a color and a form. So whatever's present for you at this time is just perfect for you at this time. And as you gently hold your awareness here in your spiritual heart, you become aware that it's moving, it's turning. It's gently moving and turning, for life is always moving. And this is the essence of life. And in this essence, in this essence, we have access to all that we need, all the answers, all the next steps, all the shifts in consciousness, the shifts in awareness. So if there's some question that has been puzzling you, you can simply place that question here in your spiritual heart and allow the answers to emerge. And they may come quickly, or they may come over time through your life. Your spiritual heart knows how to bring forward the light for the highest good. That wisdom comes forward as needed in those perfect moments and perfect ways that speak to you and show you in a way that you can experience it and understand it. And you may find that in this spiritual heart, there is joy bubbling up, or peace simply enfolding you. For this is all part of the wisdom of the heart. And in this wisdom, you can lean into what comes up as possibilities for your future, your next steps. You can lean into what it would be like through your power of imagination and through your power of faith. Take those next steps as they are shown to you. And in this, you find your strength. For the word heart comes from a Latin word to do with cor. We talk about courage, the courage of the heart. And that core, that heart of your being, is your courage. It is the loving that endures and helps you take each next step, each next breath, and emerge in the joy and greater loving. And be aware that you can do this kind of touching into your spiritual heart anytime, any place, to just step aside for a moment from the busyness, turn within, and contact this gently pulsing, moving, turning place of infinite presence within you. And we give thanks. And I like to say, Beirush Beishan, or Baruch Bashan, from the Hebrew, which means the blessings already are. And so it is. Amen.
Thank you. Inside my head and there's a dream that I want to see in the sun. Behind my eyes there is me that I've been hiding for much too long. Cause I've been too afraid to let it show. Cause I'm scared of the judgment that may follow. Always putting off my living for tomorrow. It's time to step out on faith. I gotta show my face. It's been elusive for so long. Freedom is mine today. Gotta step out on faith. It's time to show my face.
All right, Art, we'll send it over to you. I don't know why we didn't have sound then, but here we are.
All right. Good morning, everyone. And I hope you're all having a wonderful, wonderful day in your consciousness, in your heart, mind, consciousness. And here we are again for another Sunday lesson. And in case you're wondering, you know, this is, we're dressing up in silly costumes. What am I dressed as? Oh, I don't know. I just felt like putting this on. And in light of the idea, I've been called the Fresh Prince. I've been called Kid and Play, the 80s rap group. Whatever. Whatever works. Whatever works. It just feels real silly to me. So I'm going to go with it. And our subject this morning is...
If people want to see you instead of the image, I just want to remind them to click on your picture so that they can see you if they would like to have the PowerPoint slide small and you large.
Yes, great idea. Thank you, Sam. Thank you, Sam. The ways of wisdom is the subject matter this morning. In scripture, it says that wisdom is the principal thing. So seek out wisdom, and in all you're getting, get understanding. So that's an invitation for us to find the wisdom for all the moments of our lives and couple that with the power of understanding. And so if we can understand the ways in which wisdom works and some of the essential characteristics of wisdom, then it empowers us to be able to, one, consider how we are presently and currently using wisdom in our lives. And number two, to be able to elevate the quality of our wisdom to a more depthful level so that we can have the presence of God in our moment-to-moment experiences and we can navigate the challenges, the issues, the affairs, and the relationships in our lives in such a way that is very beneficial and productive. So to start, we'll start off reflecting on the definition of wisdom that Patty read off earlier in the introduction. And this is a description of wisdom that comes from the book Power Up Your Life from Holton and our good friend Paul Hasselbeck. Wisdom is the power to practically apply what is known, intuitively discern, and make heart connections. The heart connection piece is very important because as we embody and deploy wisdom, it engages our heart consciousness, and it has a heart resonance in terms of the quality of the wisdom and the potential outcomes that come from it. And from that definition, to practically apply what is known, intuitively discern, and to make heart connections, I wanted to extrapolate three of the words that we find in that definition. The words knowledge, intuition, and discernment. Knowledge, intuition, and discernment. Perhaps the very first thing that is important to understand when it comes to the ways of wisdom, and Elena so beautifully illustrated this in the meditation, and particularly at the end, that solutions and wisdom are always with us. That is exactly true. Wisdom is always with us. And every decision that we make in our lives, from the most trivial of decisions to the more complex and more in decisions that require more thought and energy. We are constantly using wisdom. You woke up this morning, perhaps you had a cup of coffee or a cup of tea this morning, and you made a decision on what you were going to wear this morning. These things are things that we do on a day-to-day basis that we don't think anything of. If you're wearing shoes at the moment, you made a decision to tie your shoes, or if you got on house shoes or whatever. Wisdom was incorporated in all of these things. Oftentimes we think of wisdom as something that's real profound and deep and heavy. And there is an element and component to wisdom where that is true. Yet even the most simplest of things, we incorporate wisdom. Say, for example, the clothes that you're wearing. You have knowledge of the clothes that you have in your wardrobe. You have a knowledge of the occasion that you were going to be engaging in this morning. And also you have a knowledge of what it is that makes you, the kinds of clothes that makes you comfortable. Again, you're in your homes as opposed to being in the sanctuary where I presently am. So I'm sure comfort is of a great importance of where you are right now. So from that knowledge, you apply a degree of discernment to decide whether you were going to wear this particular outfit as opposed to this outfit. Perhaps you read the e-blast and you saw that the idea this morning was to wear silly clothing. So you went to that section of your closet to identify something silly to wear. So you use discernment to decide that you were going to wear what you presently have on as opposed to other things that are in your wardrobe or in your closet right now. And you incorporated a degree of intuition, the wordless, unknown guidance to point your finger of discernment to what it is that you ultimately decided to wear. So you used wisdom to be able to do that. And these components, knowledge, intuition, and discernment, or another word for discernment is judgment. You use that this morning to decide what you're going to wear. In every decision that you make, everything that you navigate, you're constantly using the knowledge that you have, the intuition that you have, and the discernment that you have to be able to navigate whatever it is that you're involved with. The invitation this morning is to, again, become consciously aware of how we're presently using wisdom in our lives, and then to elevate the quality of the wisdom that we use from not just wisdom in terms of the information and the knowledge that we take in from our five senses. That's important information and context when it comes to wisdom. It's also important information and context in terms of our understanding of ourselves, our understanding of the divinity within, our understanding of our character, our likes and dislikes, and our present ability to discern. But we want to receive the invitation this morning to allow divinity to come into our application of wisdom so that our wisdom is not just based upon what the information that we take in physicality, or the information that of just what we know of ourselves, but we allow ourselves to get in the divine flow and allow divine wisdom and divine guidance to be able to flow in, so that in addition to taking in everything from our physicality, the wisdom that we get from the experiences of our lives and the learning that comes from that, we allow the divine channel to come in and give us that extra dimension of guidance and insight and right seeing, so that the things that we do and the things that we engage in and the ways that we conduct ourselves are always constantly informed by our Christ nature. That's the invitation this morning to growing into this truer, deeper awareness of wisdom. And we can certainly use this kind of divine wisdom for our times as we're navigating this coronavirus challenge that humanity is faced with and the devastating toll that it's taking on humankind. Many of us have lost loved ones and relatives, or just people that we know in general that have unfortunately lost their lives, and families are grieving, and many of our healthcare workers and our essential workers are being worked and stressed to the max, serving all of us during this time and challenge. It would be helpful that we open ourselves up to the divine flow that we are always in, the divine flow that is always active in us, and the wisdom that is contained in that divine flow, so that we can apply divine knowledge in the way of divine laws, divine principles, divine understanding, and we can apply divine discernment, and we can use divine intuition, or another word for divine intuition is divine guidance, or that still small voice that is within us that helps us to perceive the divine way of navigating the things that we're faced with. We can certainly use divine wisdom right now so that we can perceive greater realities and higher realities and perceive a new normal going forward. Because right now we're more closely attached to our home bases, and we can use divine wisdom to decide how we're going to show up once we get to a safe point, how we're going to show up once we get to a place where we can more physically engage with one another instead of the physical distancing that we're engaged in right now. We can use divine wisdom to know what is ours to do in this moment right now and moment to moment going forward. What is ours to do? We can use divine wisdom. We can grow our sense of intuition and grow our sense of knowledge and discernment and apply that in a practical way, in a way that makes heart connections, in a way that connects us more and more to the intimate beauty and divinity of ourselves, and in the way that helps us through our hearts to recognize the divine in other people. In Elena's meditation, she referred to the wisdom of the heart. Well, opening ourselves up to the divine flow in the way of divine wisdom, that is wisdom of the heart. That is wisdom of the heart. So it's really important for each and every one of us to be really prayerful and really meditative so as to condition our heart, mind, consciousness to not only be influenced and to take in what we take in from our five senses, but also to take in that sixth sense, if you will. That divine guidance, that divine seeing, that divine insight, that divine wisdom that really gives us the truest picture of what it is that we're dealing with. So however we are looking at the situations of our lives, and if we want to know how to understand how we're currently applying wisdom, the only thing that we have to do is take in the situations of our lives, take in our home life, our family life, the quality of our relationships, the quality of our finances and our health. And these will give us clues and indicators of how we are currently applying wisdom. If we see that we want to experience more richness and enjoyment in life, we can draw in divine wisdom so that we take in more than just our intellect and our academic level and what we take in from our senses. We're taking in God wisdom so that we see the facets of our lives through the eyes of God, as opposed to looking for God through our problems and through our challenges. Because in God wisdom, there's always a whole in every part. There's always an allness within every illness, as Eric Butterworth would say. Within every state of confusion, there's always a cosmos. And in any situation that through our human understanding, we would define as being like hell, heaven is present right in the midst of that. And speaking of that, I wanted to turn to scripture this morning, to the book of James, chapter 3, verse 17. And this gives us understanding of how wisdom, the essential characteristics of wisdom. But the wisdom that comes from heaven, or that comes from the divine, is first of all pure, then peace-loving, considerate, submissive, full of mercy, and good fruit, impartial and sincere. The wisdom comes from heaven. Again, it comes from the Christ within us, flowing through in that divine flow into our conscious awareness. It's peace-loving in that wisdom always has a bias towards promoting, establishing, and magnifying peace. It's considerate and submissive in the fact that it doesn't often scream loud. Often we have to learn to lowly listen in our own unique way to hear the voice of wisdom within. It's full of mercy in the sense that regardless to how badly we might feel we stunk it up and made some sort of wrong choice, wisdom always has a bias for our highest good. And it always recognizes our divinity. And that's where the mercy comes in. And when we act on wisdom, it produces good fruit. And it has an impartial and sincere quality to it. So these are the ways of wisdom. And our invitation is to be like the reed in the wind, to be able to perceive the wisdom that is coming to us from the divine, and be able to adjust and shift our consciousness, our behaviors, as well as our actions, to meet what wisdom requires. I know for me, and I'm sure this is true for you, you've had many situations where the facts of a situation might indicate you do one thing, but then you have some sort of internal prompting that you're seeing, sensing, feeling, and knowing that this is what the facts are, but I'm being moved and led and guided to go in this direction. When I'm sick, I affirm health. When something comes in that might move me to fear, if I'm feeling fear, I'll acknowledge it, but I will affirm the presence of God, which will help me to navigate the situation to where fear is not even a thing, because we know from scripture, we haven't been given a spirit of fear. We've been given a spirit of courage. So each of us has this divine wisdom. We have used it. However, take the invitation to allow the divine to come in to give you right seeing, right hearing, and a right tongue to line up with wisdom and watch your life unfold beautifully and watch your life be filled with magic and love and wonder and joy. Thank you so much. God bless you.
Wow, we are certainly blessed here at Unity of Wichita for our live service by Art Handy's wonderful message, Elena Merriman's wonderful meditations and affirmations, Bruce Moxley's beautiful singing. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And let's remember Sam Jones, who puts this all together. If it wasn't for her, none of this would be happening. And so we are grateful, grateful, grateful. And thank you, thank you, thank you. And to each one of you who have made the effort to take the time to join us on this Zoom live streaming experience. I mean, we can feel the love even through the screens of our phones and our computers. And so please consider giving a tithe or an offering to Unity of Wichita. You can go to the donation page at www.unityofwichita.org/ donations. That's www.unityofwichita.org/donations to give a secure financial gift. Whatever amount you are guided to give today, just visualize that electronic tithe, or you can mail it into the church as well, and bless it with your love. And please join us in our offering blessing together.
Divine love
flowing from me blesses and multiplies
all that I am,
all that I give, and all that I receive. And I am grateful.
Amen. Amen. And right now we envision our tithes and our offerings that we have given and that we will give. And we just infuse that with love, as Patty mentioned, and energy and grace and joy. And we affirm that our tithes and offerings go forth and flow forth using wisdom in ways that bless, in ways that nurture, in ways that fortify, in ways that inspire minds, open hearts, and liberates and quickens spirits. We are so grateful for the law of giving and receiving, the law of circulation, and to participate in those laws, express those laws, knowing that it is God that is our infinite source of supply. We are so grateful, and together we say, and so it is. Amen. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you so much for your tithes and your offerings. And now this time, we'll go into announcements. So my spiritual partner in crime, or my partner in spirit, Sam Jones.
Good morning, everyone. So we don't really have announcements that I prepared. I apologize. I kind of had some last minute changes. But I do want to mention the questions for the discussion following. Again, we'll introduce ourselves with our name and your aha moment. What struck you about today's service? Maybe it was how much we are grateful for our music team, Bruce and Virginia, because we miss Virginia so much. And we finally got to hear Bruce again after being so long without him. That was wonderful. But also, right after you guys share those questions, your aha moment, it would be really great if you could share, what wisdom have you gained? What wisdom have you gained through this process? And it can be anything. It can be that, you know, you've learned that you're not a great stay-at-home parent. Who knows? But that's the discussion questions following service today. So I'll kick it back over to Art. Thanks.
All right. Thank you all so much for joining. And we want to, before we leave, we want to think of our youth, all of the wonderful youth that are connected to this service. Some of you may be watching right now. We want to extend our hands and just radiate out love and joy to the youth in our spiritual community. And we see the youth blessing. Let us affirm together. We love you. We bless you. We appreciate you. And we behold the Christ as you, just as you are, just as you are. And just as you are, thank you so much for connecting with us this morning and making this a wonderful Sunday experience. And we will now go into the affirming our prayer protection and singing our peace song. So you can see there on the monitor, let's affirm together. The light of God surrounds us. I am the light of God. The love of God enfolds us. I am the love of God. The power of God protects us. I am the power of God. The presence of God watches over us. I am the presence of God. Wherever we are, wherever we are, God is, and all is well.
We're here.
Oh, okay.
We're back.